her male fragility show coming up in September at the Shout House, and shows that she does with the queer feminist comedy collective, That's What She Said.
So I decide to cry because I think that it's my fault. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is
intimacy issues until then, but that was my worst time having sex. Are you guys ready for the best time?
Yeah!
Best time. The best sex I ever had. The person is here tonight. Yes. My first year into living in Portland. I moved here for graduate school. I just got dumped by this really horrible person. I was in that, like, maybe I should call him and we should work it out phase. Right. My friend Julie's like, he sucks. We all hated him. Do not call him back. Please look at two people on the internet. So I was like, okay. So I found a person on OkCupid who, when they said was matched up with me 95%, it was actually a legit statement. I met this person, and it was like I'd known them my whole life. Our first date lasted 2 weeks. The first time we met, we had sex for 10 hours. That's why I have all those divots in my bed, guys. First time we met, but the best sex we ever had was the second week of our first date, which is the best sentence in the world. The second week of our first date, I was in this really weird art show for school, and I had this performance. I just decided to become a performance artist, and I was kind of nervous about it. And I was doing this art show where I was reenacting this situation where I had gone to a store to buy a dress, and this pregnant woman was like acting like we were best friends, and she's like, "I'm fat too," and I was like, "It's not the same." And so I was reenacting that, me being myself and her at the same time, just like switching to different sides of the table. So I do my performance. He calls in sick to work to come see me perform. Right? So I do my performance. It's great. We head home. We're a little drunk. We're fooling around. We start having sex. And it's like already amazing sex. We know we're both into each other. We're having good sex. And then he starts critiquing my performance. He's saying really wonderful things. He's like, "You did really good tonight. And like, the things that you say are really important." And like, I'm like, and then he starts saying really, really sweet things that are like, "The performances you're doing are changing people's lives. You need to keep doing this. You have a natural talent." Keep in mind, it's like one of these situations. He's like, "You're really good." And I'm like, "Thanks." So he's telling me this, and I start to cry. Because I know he's being genuine. Because, you know, he's not blowing smoke up my ass, because he's literally in my pants at this moment. So I know he's telling the truth. He has no reason to lie right now. So I start to cry. And he thinks there's something wrong. And I'm like, no, these are happy tears. Then he starts to cry. So then we're like crying and sweating, and it's like, is that like you're sweating my eye or your tears, or those my tears? What's happening? So we're just crying all over each other. And it's like the best thing ever, and we both come at the same time. And it's one of those like orgasms where you're like, "Did I just shoot to a different planet?" Probably. So we both come at the same time, and I guess my life advice for everybody would be find a person who can literally fuck a good critique into you. And then afterwards have a naked pizza party together.